Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, our next bout of the evening, Mr. Lee Eaton, in association with Vinco Boxing, proudly presents 6 rounds of action in the welterweight division. Sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control, our supervisor here at ringside, Mr. Matt Harris. Our timekeeper at the bell for this contest, Mr. Tony Dunkley, and our referee in charge of the action, Mr. Stephen Gray. So introducing to you first, boxing out of the red corner, his official weight on the scales, 9 stone, 13 pounds. An experienced boxer with over 150 bouts to his name, wearing the blue and gray shorts from Stockport, the Devil's Child, Jamie Quinn. His opponent tonight, standing across the ring, boxing out of the blue corner, his official weight on the scales, 10 stone, 2 pounds, 9 ounces. He enters tonight with a professional record, 8 victories, 1 defeat, wearing the black and white shorts from Birmingham, presenting T.O. Our referee, Mr. Stephen Gray, to give his final instructions.
Okay, boys, the cold break. Step back straight away. Don't punch around the back of the head. Protect yourselves at all times. Touch gloves.
Okay, Ricky, here we go, mate. It's Teon Gibbs against Jamie Quinn. And just as I say this, Chris is back on the mic. But here we go. It's going to be a good one, this. Jamie's as tough as they come, but Teon is a good prospect coming through, trained by Max McCracken. Yeah, and I'm looking forward to this one.
Yeah, it's going to be a good fight, this, Aki.
Aki's gone. You've got me back, Ricky.
Yes. Welcome back, Chris.
Looking forward to this one, actually. Teon Gibbs against someone I know very well, Jamie Quinn.
So this is a Max McCracken trained fighter, the Gibbs lad, up here against a Northside lad in Jamie Quinn, if I'm not mistaken, in the lightweight division.
From a boxing family, Teon. His brother Connor. He's a pro boxer.
Is that the same lad who won the boxer tournament, I believe?
That's right, yeah.
Yes, yeah. I remember, yeah.
His name was actually on the box rack. His brother's name instead of Teon, but 8-1 as a pro. This is a lad who was saying earlier had been over to Peter Fury's gym sparring with Savannah.
Yes, I understand, yes, yeah.
In a run-up to the Clarissa Shields fight.
Yeah, the Shields fight, yeah, so he's been in a good stead there, you know, down there.
He looks like a well-schooled fighter, doesn't he? Again, I don't know much about his amateur career, but you can see he's...
He's very educated.
Educated fighter, yeah. Jamie Quinn. I don't know if they still call him the Devil Child Quinn.
Yeah, that's right. That's what they called him, brother. That's what they just announced.
But he can be... I mean, I remember, I don't know what he's on now. How many fights has he had now? Did it say he's 150 maybe?
Yeah, 150, I believe it was, yeah.
I remember doing an interview with him just before his 100th fight, and he was going to call it a day at 100, and I think a week later he made a comeback.
Well, you see, there you go. It's the bug of boxing.
Jamie, again, like we spoke about, Harry Matthews in the fight before, will always give young prospects, you know, run for the money, give them good rounds, give them the experience. He knows how to, well, he knows his way around the ring inside out, every trick in the book.
Most definitely. People like Jamie Quinn, boxing needs, you know, that, you know, they need to get that together here. You know, if it wasn't for that, these young prospects or you know, debutants wouldn't be prospects and debutants if it wasn't for these guys. So big respect to them. Good first round there from Gibbs.
Seconds out, round two.
Round number two. Tion Gibbs versus Jamie Quinn. Tion's from Birmingham, the Max McCracken gym. Same as Raza Hamza, who tops the bill tonight. Very good gym, renowned for producing boxers and in Birmingham.
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah, Max McCracken's gym, you know, famous brother, as everyone knows. GB coach, former trainer of Anthony Joshua, Rob McCracken. So, you know, they're a well-schooled family, so they know what they're looking at with boxers.
I did an interview with Raza Hamza, who's topping the bill last week or week before, and he was speaking very highly of Max and saying what, like, he, you know, he's a father figure to the boxers in the gym there. And you find out with a lot of boxing coaches, don't they? It's like a second father they become to the boxers. You're with them more than you probably are with anybody.
Most definitely, you know. I mean, I see more of Terry than what I do anybody. You know, we're always together. You know, we're never apart from one another, really. So it's good that you've got that connection, though. It's what you want with the trainer, you know what I mean? Someone who's got the best interest at heart. Lovely body shot there from Gibbs.
I like how he's looking for the openings. He was looking at the head there and sunk one down to the body, and he's fainting slightly. I think that's what you need to do with, you know, these fighters who cover up, who are very experienced. You need to do something different.
That disguise, it's got to be that disguise. You've got to disguise it. Jamie Quinn's a very tough man, you know, you can see that of him in there, you know what I mean, a very tough man, knows this ring, you know, as good as he knows his own front room.
Well, 9 fights for Tion. He lost his last fight, actually. It was a split decision. Now, I didn't see that one, it was against Scott Melvin. That was in April. So we're looking to get back to winning ways there.
Yeah, getting back to winning ways. I'm most importantly, you know, coming back against, you know, someone who knows the ring and you know, getting back to winning ways and finding the ring again, you know, because it's been a long time since he's been out. So here he is again now, you know, shouting his stuff in front of the crowd, you know, which is good.
Yeah, the last fight, Scott Melvin. So it was actually a Midlands derby, that Birmingham derby fight. Scott Melville, again, a winning record as well, so maybe that's a fight that he might be looking to get. I didn't see that fight, but it looks like it was close, split decision. Maybe it's a fight he'd like to get again going forward.
Exactly, you know, 100%. If it was close in a split decision, it could go again.
Round number three in the career of young prospect Tion Gibbs from Birmingham against Jamie Devil Child Quinn.
They just give you a lovely wave there.
Jamie, yeah. I've known you a long time, Jamie, and good lad. he's having a chat
to him there with him in the ring. They're having a laugh here.
The thing with Jamie, anyone will tell you as well, the young lads who even spar him or whatever, you know, and who have fought him as well, and he's always got it there to turn it on, you know, and any of these young, like we said earlier, any young prospects...
got a kink in their armour.
He'll take it. I mean, he does his job, and these fighters who are in every week, they've got to keep themselves in good, tip-top condition at the end of the day.
Yeah, that's how it works.
You've got to know how to survive. They can't be getting in there, getting, you know, beat up every week, or they won't make it the week after. So
most definitely, you know what. But Gibbsy, you know, controlling the action, you know, using his jab, giving variety, you know, moving well, as we can see, you know, feinting well. You know, when he's boxing off this lead jab, it's lovely stuff to watch, such as the movement there. It's nice stuff.
I do like look at Gibbs though. He's a good boxer. Relies a lot on his reflexes. His low arms.
Yeah,
he's got good footwork.
Yeah,
timing.
Yeah, you know, that's something where you go in the gym with that. So that's something he's had. You know, that's something what he'd have gone with the gym with. And all you do with that is you just bring it out a bit more at a time. You know, he hasn't naturally got that come forward sort of a bully style. You know, he's a boxer, and you can see that from a mile off.
Self-preservation, I think the word I was looking for before, of Jamie Quinn. Preserves himself well for the week after.
Yeah, most definitely. Cleary's coach there saying to work the body, you know, you can hear that from McCracken there saying to work the body. I don't think it's a bad suggestion, you know. Get that jab back pumping again and work the body.
Tion Gibbs versus Jamie Quinn.
Yeah, off we go to round four, you know.
You know, he said there, his corner had said, come out, get that jab working now.
Yeah, 100%. He's working the body now as well. So, you know, it's nice to see when you're seeing your opponent work your body, you know, as well as a good jab such as there. Beautiful, beautiful lateral movement there from Gibbs. You know, knowing the score there. Beautiful, right up to the body. Back behind that jab now. There we go. Beautiful boxing this from Gibbs.
Yeah, do it like look of him, Ricky. Good boxer.
Yeah, very well schooled.
They're having fun.
Most definitely, you know, 100%. Two great tango partners here. But Gibbs has got lead role. He's giving him the waltz. Can't get back on that jab. Everything's coming lovely for Gibbs off the jab. Everything off his left hand's been beautiful to see. Lateral movement, he's been working the body really well, but he's been jabbing, you know, more or less on point.
I mean, it was a few years ago now. Jamie Quinn, he fought him twice, Zelfa Barrett. And the first time he fought him, Zelfa's opponent pulled out late. I mean, on the day late, a couple of hours before, and he won't have an opponent anyway. The matchmaker rang up Jamie, who just had his tea, spaghetti bolognese, taking a dog out for a walk. Next minute, he jumped in a taxi and was at the venue and took Zelfa on, took him the four rounds with a belly full of spaghetti bolognese.
Well, if that doesn't show a fighting man, I don't know what doesn't. There you go, man's just had his food and jumped straight up in the car and gone and had a fight. What a man. So here we go, Tion Gibbs, Jamie Quinn, fifth round, and here we go.
I thought it was a four rounder, that one.
Hey.
Okay. Six rounder though, which makes sense. Tion, he's had nine fights.
Lovely shot there to the body.
I mean, chances are, you know, you've got to be good to get someone like Jamie Quinn out of there. He very, very rarely gets stopped. So it becomes about, you know, if you're not going to get rid of him that easily, it's a chance just to work on new things.
Of course, you know, whatever his trainer's been teaching him in the gym, you know, what they've been going on as a game plan, you know, get it into practice now with this gentleman. And then most importantly as well, like you said, is to try out new things. You know, you realise there's not much danger coming back, so it's time now to work on stuff that you don't usually work on and perfect it.
Starting to work Jamie's body a bit here now. Tion and a few of them have reddened in the ribs there of Jamie.
Yeah, most definitely. As you can see, you know, showing lovely lateral movement. What I can see of this Tion Gibbs, as well as his punching stats, he's got really, really good punch selection, and I like his lateral movement. He's got lovely lateral movement, and he picks his punches really well. Look, as you can see there, he's just out of range. You know, he's dictating the pace of his opponent. He's boxing really well.
Yeah, he's got a nice style. Like you said, good footwork, good reflexes, timing. Good style, fluid. He's definitely a good prospect, Tion Gibbs, someone to look out for. And it's the sort of fight you'd like to see again and watch his progression, because you can see he's got a lot to give, and
definitely,
I'm sure he'll get better and better as he moves up.
Definitely, I am switching angles there, you know. It's nice to see, you know, he's not just coming in a straight line. Lovely round that for Gibbs.
Corners, 10 seconds. Seconds out for the sixth and final round.
This is definitely the last round now, Ricky. Sixth and final round.
Yeah, it's been a good display this by Gibbs. You know, he's controlled the full five rounds. You know, he's showed some really good skills. Shows some good lateral movement, some good angles, and very good selections of punches, which you wouldn't expect no different coming out of the Max McCracken camp.
Sneaky body shot there, I think. Yeah,
disguising his punch is lovely, you know. He really is. Just noticing that now, Chris, to be honest with you. Disguising that body shot really nice. And there's that lateral movement again.
Yeah, like, he cocked the left hook and thrown the right up to the body. You see how Jamie's just got all them little turns.
Knows how to ride that sting out of them punches. That's what he does, yeah. You know, the man's a natural survivor, and he's doing a really good job of this right now.
Very hard to land clean on him. He's messing about there.
Yeah, 100%.
He's an entertainer.
Yeah. Most certainly. Good 1-2 there down the pipe there from Gibbs.
Yeah.
And again. I believe Gibbs has controlled this fight really well. You know, he's composed himself for it as well, Chris, really well. Good, yeah. Like I say, lateral movement. He sticked the boxes off, hasn't he, at the end of the day. So, whatever, as he's been working on the gym, it's showing now in this performance, and he's looking really good, and it's going to be nice seeing him in other fights.
It is. Very impressive. Look forward to seeing him again. So he's a thinking fighter.
Yeah, he's definitely a counterpuncher at heart. You can see that, especially the way he feints and he waits. You know, he's the sort of person what prefers the press there is the press to come to him rather than him look for it. He's a good kid.
And with his foot movement, he can be in range, but you know, out of range as well. He's that quick. You might think he's there and he's see ya.
Yeah, 100%. You know. He's got lovely feet, you know, and the way to mannerism them feet is by, you know, having really, really, really good pressure and skills, which he needs to Jamie here now, you know, putting his back up against the ropes, having a relax. Great fight. Well done.
Well done to both lads there.
Most definite. Well done to both of them.
The scores are in. Over to our MC, Jonathan Millard, the voice of the Vale, the result.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, after six rounds of boxing, we go to our referee's scorecard. Referee Steve Gray scores the contest 60-54 for your winner from Birmingham, T.O. Gibbs.
Shut out there, you know, absolute one on all cards there, you know, every round, so good performance from the kid.
Look out for T.O. Gibbs. Third fight there of the evening. Next up, Ricky, we have Danny Quartermain versus Sanjit Singh. 6-0, Danny. Another prospect.
Yeah, he's walking. Yeah, he's walking into this with a 6-0 record. You know, he's gonna be wanting to show his stuff in front of the some of his fans. You know, he's a local lad, so here we go.
Okay, there. I'm here with the one and only, the British and former British and Commonwealth champion, Frankie Gavin. Frankie, now you know Tion Gibbs really well, don't you? But
yeah,
he was in there with tough Jamie Quinn, and these away fighters tonight have come to give it. I think the boys in commentary enjoyed it, but how did you enjoy that one?
It was good, yeah. Obviously, he weren't going to get him out of there. He's a tough guy, so I think he had to take his time, pick his shots. But I think Tion showed his class tonight, I really do.
Now, tonight we're going to be hearing a lot more from Frankie. After the next fight, we're having a bit of a 10-minute break. We're going to hear a lot more about Frankie, what he's up to. Because obviously, around these parts, you're a bit of a legend, mate, aren't you?
In the boxing perspective, yes.
Well, they say that you were one of the best amateurs to ever come out of this country, mate. And you were, weren't you, as well?
I think so. I think my record speaks for itself. I don't want to sound big-headed or not. Well, I won the world. I'm still the only person to ever win it. So, yeah, I've done well.
Mate, you did absolutely brilliantly. We're going to speak to Frankie a lot more when we have the 10-minute break after the next fight. Next up, we have Danny Quartermain against Sarjit Singh. You know a bit about Danny Quartermain, don't you?
Yeah, he's got a very big following. He's from Leamington. He does well for himself. So hopefully we'll see a big performance.
Got to make sure. You got to keep up with these away fighters tonight because they're really good. They're tough guys. Any tips for like the young fighters coming through, the prospects coming through?
Just don't try and knock them out straight away because they're tough. They'll hit you with their head. You got to take your time with them, pick your shots and see how it goes.
All right, well, a lot more from Frankie Gavin to come. Of course, he was a Commonwealth gold medalist as well as an amateur. He did it all as an amateur. We'll talk a lot more about that. Next up, guys, as I mentioned, Danny Quartermain. He's 6-0, hoping to go 7-0. He's in there against Sarjit Singh. It's going to be a good fight, this one. So I hope you're enjoying everything, and thanks for staying with us.